Hello, Internet! I hope everyone's having an awesome Christmas. I brought the stream up a little bit early, so if you're watching this later on YouTube and you're like really, you know, detail-minded and you're like, you have more points than you did last time. I suspect something weird is going on. It's because I tried to give us some more points before starting and then returned us to here. And in the process, complain a lot about Star Trek, apparently. But why am I vibrating? That's a good question. I'm like, I see no reason why I should be vibrating. Just take my phone out of my pocket. And it is... Don't care. Okay, I have a text. That I actually did care about. The car stuff is coming to a close, so that should no longer be interfering with things. The holidays are winding down. We're still only doing 3-hour streams this week. I'm going to endeavor to go see Rogue One tonight. Hopefully that will not be something I will be complaining about tomorrow. I suspect I won't be, but I am cautiously optimistic. For a shitty year, I'd like to at least have some nice way of topping it off. I mean, like, we could talk about the shitty stuff that, like... I don't know if I can say anything else about missing Carrie Fisher than anyone else has online. I mean, I feel like if I don't say something, I'd almost be remiss, though. But... yeah. The world is definitely slightly shittier than on Monday when we streamed last. And it fucking sucks. And despite the fact that it was very likely gonna happen, I mean, she was not breathing for a good while before when the plane thing happened. I don't really buy into, like, cult of celebrity bullshit or anything. At least nowhere near as much as I used to. I'm gonna leave him come back in so I can not fuck that up. But she seemed like a really genuine person, and it's not, like... it's not Star Wars that I think I really enjoyed Carrie for. It's all the other bullshit. The cynicism in Hollywood, Carrie. So, but I don't have anything else I can really, I'm not gonna be able to put it better than anyone else on the internet. It just fucking sucks. And 2016's not over yet, and I'm sure 2017's not gonna be that bad, and not gonna be that much better, but, you know what, when you got a scapegoat, you gotta scape that goat. I don't know how one scapes a goat. But I'm gonna do my best, and I'm gonna join the mob, and we're gonna escape the goat.
Let's go.
So I'm assuming the horse is gonna summon another ogre to replace the one I killed, because that's what it did last time. Because it's an asshole. Chaos, can you target the one in the back at all with, like, ice wings? Hey, you can. I'd watch that. Farscape is something I kept trying to get into. I have watched, like, the first couple seasons of Farscape. And I really have wanted to be able to try and get into it. And I don't know, there's just... I like some of the characters, I find a lot of the time I end up being kind of bored by some of the stories, and I don't like that, because I like liking things, and I think there's a lot of interesting things about that show's visual design, but Like, I think there's a lot of things about that show that they did really well. I'm bored most of the time watching it. Ready? Lunar seal. And I don't know, maybe it's just like 21 episodes a season TV shows are just not for me. I mean, I could definitely do with like more succinct story arcs. I think the problem too is it like by the time the writing gets better, what's the best way of putting this? The plots start getting repetitious. And maybe it's one of those things that I should have just, like, got a viewing guide for or something, but whatevers. Whatever, I'll do what I want.
Let's go!
These fights are mean. Because that unicorn just keeps bringing things back. Like, unicorn, this is not the fucking 80s or something. I don't know. I don't know where I was going with that concept. Hey, he looks like he's, like, got one knee that really wants to give out on him, doesn't he? So what the fuck's the unicorn gonna do this time? Okay. Alright. Yeah, see, that's what I thought. We're gonna do that. And then Cosmos. Once you attack once. Stop. I wish I could boost someone right now. Okay, so like that does no damage to the thing. Oh god! Okay, so it looks like once you get rid of the front two, it hasn't brought them back, but you know. I'm not exactly expecting that to keep going, but it looks like this is a core hound situation where you have to bring them down all at once, or you know, within close proximity to each other. I remember dealing with the Core Hound packs. I love the Core Hounds. They're so adorable. Like, if I were to pick my second favorite monster from WoW, because... or Warcraft, but I don't think the Core Hounds are in Warcraft, other than WoW. It would be the Core Hounds. First favorites being the Murlocs, because I fucking love the Murlocs. I found out Blizzard sells Murloc mugs on the Battle.net store or whatever it is, or the Blizzard store, and I'm like, oh god, why did I search for that? Because now there's something that I didn't know that existed previously that I now really wish I had. Alright, so we can't get in there yet, but whatever. Like, I'm not the kind of person that just wants to jump at buying something, but I was like, huh, I wonder what else there is. Like, maybe somebody on Etsy's made some cool, some cool Murloc crap, right? And then I ended up on the official Blizzard store, and I was like, oh god. And then I saw that they had a Stitches plush, and I was like, no! No, stop showing me things! Like, come over here. I need you to come over here. Come here. Come here. Where's you?
All battle systems are go.
Okay. Oh shit, I shouldn't have done that. Okay, stop there, because that thing's low enough.
Let's go!
But I love having, like, just weird mugs. So... I would not be surprised if I somehow convinced my husband to get that or something for me. Maybe a birthday present. Okay, so we got two of these guys to take down. Chaos right now. Chaos, you attack this one.
Ready? Lunar seal.
Because I think that should be enough to take that down. Yep. And then, Cosmos, go, like, all in on this one, please. That's actually probably enough. Yeah, it was 300 and some, so 400 is definitely enough. Okay, I'm gonna boost Chaos back in. Okay, and let's boost Ziggy back in. And then it's going to attack somebody. Ow. But whatever. But yeah, this Stitches plus is fucking adorable. Other than I looked at, like, I guess they, it's more based off of the Heroes of the Storm model of him, but... It's one of those things that, like, the 3D model works nowhere near as well as the plush does. Like, I look at the 3D model and I'm like, good god, what have you done to Stitches? You made him all, like, weird. I mean, he was already kind of weird, but still. Okay, yeah, we're really close to getting this done.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's enough.
Let's go.
I seriously don't remember this RPG being as strategic as I'm having to play it. Did I, like, just... I must have, like, somehow completely blocked it out. Well, he'd have to be, right? To, like, be the same size as the other heroes. My husband doesn't remember anyone ever kiting Stitches to Goldshire, and I'm like, how do you not remember that? That was, like, the best part of Stitches. Is trying to kite him to Goldshire and just cause chaos. I mean, I think it's probably the troll in me that likes doing that, but he's probably just not as much of a troll as I am. I just remember it was always so funny watching, like, the NPC guards. I'm not sure when he started playing. Sometime in vanilla? But I really don't remember. And he's not home right now, so I couldn't even ask him. He's dealing with car stuff for us, because he is awesome. And mostly because it's, you know, predominantly... He's our predominant driver, so... Okay, we gotta figure out where to go from here. Mm-hmm. What is going on there? Okay. Did we already go over this way? I can't remember if we did or not. Okay. Are we going into a cutscene?
It looks like we've arrived
at the center. I didn't want to be at the center, and I'm sorry about the shadows being all weird and fucked up, but it's really the only option, I guess.
A building?
Oh yeah, at least it looks like we have to go in there.
Maybe some sort of device?
What do you mean?
I don't know. It's just...
Yes?
Well, if this is really the center, it's possible...
That looks like a Zohan. Or Zohar. I can't remember which one is the Adam Sandler movie and which one is the friggin' giant pillar, and that's terrible.
In other words, if that is a man-made object, it could be a ship or some other wreckage that was swallowed just as we were.
Also, we did see the ship blow up on screen. Ganon reminded me.
We'll be sure to get out of here before that happens.
Sometime earlier in the week.
What's the Elsa's current position?
Location unknown. I have lost its signal.
Lost?
The Gnosis magnetic and gravitational fields have become unstable near the center.
I read. I was actually looking at the WoW wiki for Stitches, Mux, and
That's pretty close.
They like made him instanced now, yes. Like with Kata. Like the encounter's instanced. And I'm like, ugh, that's so stupid. Part of the fun was like having everyone band together and like, oh, we gotta run off and deal with Stitches now. It was kind of a nuisance, but it was like a nuisance in a way that was a community nuisance, right? Oh, there's another Zohar.
Good.
Commander, why was I assigned this mission?
I wanted to test your loyalty to the organization. Nothing more. The citizens will be affected, whether you succeed or not.
Interesting.
Do you regret your decision?
No. They're of no consequence to me, nor to our organization, or anyone else.
I'm assuming that test is not going to go well.
Well said, Cherenkov.
Yeah, Margulis, I guess, blew up that planet that the giant Gnosis ate the leftover bits of. The giant Gnosis that were now inside or whatever. I don't know. Yeah, it's not... That's one thing I don't like about MMOs is... You can't just go back. But, I mean, like, at the same time, I feel like games need to evolve, and the problem is migrating a player base, right? Like, how do you do that? There's no good answer. Is basically the only thing you can say. That was really funny.
Hilbert effect active. Gnosis materialization complete.
Alright, so then that and then that.
Lunar seal.
I mean, didn't EverQuest 2 shut down, but EverQuest is still going or something? I think for another MMO to properly succeed, they need to figure out a way to maintain a player base across evolving the game. Really. Because otherwise, you're just going to end up locked in. Like the everyone is now. I think that's basically going to be the big evolution in an MMO structure. Or at least I think it needs to be, right? Alright, you guys use lightning spells, so I probably shouldn't use lightning on you. Holy fuck dicks! Alright, well, let's get rid of that fucking ogre now. I always wanted to play EverQuest, I just didn't have the money to when I was growing up. And then by the time that I actually had the money to, WoW was coming out, and it was just like, well, why would I go play EverQuest now? Considering that WoW was, like, going into a world that I was already familiar with. You gonna put someone to sleep? Hurry up! I've heard some really good things about Final Fantasy XIV that make me want to try it. It's just part of me doesn't want to get sucked into another MMO. I mean, so much of my game backlog right now is because I played WoW. Right? Like, there are a lot of games that I just didn't play because I was playing WoW at the time. And I was like, whatever, you know, I'll just get to that. And then, I don't know. Where is this? Well, no. Your life shot is cheaper. I would have to play any kind of MMO I try to join as, like, casually as fuck, probably. And even then, on top of that, like... Hey, I'm going in a circle, aren't I? And over here is the... Did I already fight the guy over here? Yeah, I already did. Alright, I know where I am. This is just a big loop over here that I went one way the first time, and now I'm going the other way. I just want to double check that I'm right on this. Yeah, because here's the area down... Oh, God! The bees! Commencing combat. Yeah, I've heard good things about Elder Scrolls Online. But, I mean, like... If Oblivion says anything to me, I'm not really hugely in love with the Oblivion setting, or the Elder Scrolls setting. I really love Skyrim, but Oblivion just was like, okay, this isn't Skyrim, I want this to be Skyrim. And I'm having fun, but this isn't Skyrim, right? This is such a big lead up for such a small amount of damage. Yeah. I played Rift a bit, and I really liked Rift, but the problem with Rift was there was never anything that really stood out about Rift. It had things I liked about it. Like, I definitely enjoyed the time I spent playing it. I don't know if that's enough to kill that. I gotta do one more attack.
Let's go.
And Final Fantasy XIV, like I said, I've heard some really good things about. I've also heard some good things about the Old Republic. But again, it's... I don't know.
Ready? Lunar seal.
Those games tend to be populated with so much... Like, there's so much focus on giving the players activities to do over top of just telling a good story that... Now, like I said, that's one of the things I've heard about both the Old Republic and Final Fantasy XIV is that they do have a stronger focus on story, but... Yeah, this is exactly where I thought this was. I'm going back this way so we can go in that main building back here. I think that's the other thing, too, is, like, after you play one MMO, I mean, first, I always feel like your first MMO is going to be kind of special, no matter what. Like, it's just kind of the nature of the beast, you know? But also, like, a lot of the game mechanics are similar, so you're not, like, you're just going to be playing a lot of the same stuff with a different... It's like a palette swap, right? You know, Jedis instead of orcs, or what have you. And sometimes story or gameplay, you know, minutia can make up for that or make it more than that. No, not Chaos. Why did I pick Chaos? I meant to pick Momo. But it's not always the case. Actually, I'd say more often than not, it's not the case. Like, really, playing Rift felt a lot like playing WoW. The main differences being the, hello. Alright, should I go back and make a save? You know what, we're gonna pretend like we walk back, and we're gonna cheese this and make a save state here. Because I didn't make a save state at the start of the stream anyway. I have no idea what these guys are like. May you be reborn again anew. Lizard men. They don't look like lizards. I mean, they kind of do, but lizards tend not to have wings. They look more like grasshopper men. I didn't even pay attention to how many hit points those have. Really should have. That looks good, though, but... Ow! Oh, okay, stop biting my face. Biting your face is what we like to do. Yeah, they don't look like lizards. They look like insects. Okay, we are Cosmos right now. Let's do Blaster, our cannon. And then we'll have Ziggy attack one of them. That has, like, not a lot of hit points left, because, like, yeah, whatever. Okay, 88. Yeah, Ziggy, high kick him. And then jackknife.
Yeah.
Then that way it'll take him out of the thing in the corner there, the turn order. Not that that's necessarily going to be, like, saving us, but... Wow, these guys are assholes. I should see if I have any immunity to poison skills, and if I don't, see if I can, like, learn some. Okay, tornado slash. Stop, then you'll take poison damage. Holy crap, that's a lot of poison damage. Okay. Yeah, they don't look like lizard men at all. But again, that could be, like, a translation thing, right? Yeah, I'm just gonna suck up the damage. Let's see if we can get a boost bonus at all. Or not! That didn't kill him. Fuck you. That killed him.
Don't take it too hard.
Okay, at least the status effects don't seem to stay in, like, once you exit out of combat. Let's use you to heal everyone. Okay, what do we have for skills? Because I could really use a, like, immunity. Yeah, poison guard right here. Prevents poison. Okay, so I'm going to take off ether attack down and put on poison guard for you. and put on... Okay, so you need to learn Poison Guard. Ziggy has Poison Guard. What did we learn Poison Guard from? Snake Hunter. There. And then set... actually, no. Turn that one off and put that one on. There. And I don't need two guys with Search Eyes on, so Ziggy, takes Search Eyes... Actually, no, Ziggy's probably best to have Search Eyes on, and you can take Search Eyes off. For now, at least. There. That should help.
I guess there's no choice but to fight.
Yeah, I mean, like, there's always a choice. And then, okay, so there's 133 there. So then you just do Lunar Seal, and then we'll kill him and come back around. It's always a choice! This isn't no choice, actually a choice. I don't know why I'm doing Camp German. Camp down German, accent von Buta, Buta. It has been a fucking frustrating December. I mean, streaming's been really good. I have nothing to complain about with streaming, really. But it's just everything else. It has been a long and tiring December. Isn't that like a Counting Crows song?
Watch the enemy closely and react quickly.
I don't think I know that Linkin Park song. I might actually, like, it might be one of those things where I know the song, but I don't know the actual name of it. There we go, that's much better. My husband does that all the time, he's like, you've never heard that song? And I'm like, I don't know. I mean, like, I don't know the names of things. Die! Okay. I really am, and like, this game is so weird. I don't get why I don't remember it. I remember Final Fantasy X that I played around the exact same time period really well. Now maybe it's because I played Final Fantasy X more than once, and I only ever played this once. But I seriously do not remember any of the complexity of this game at all. Ugh, okay, I would rather try and get bonus points for killing him, but I don't want him to have a turn. So, he can go die in a pile of dissipation. Okay. hamburger hook? I think I haven't. I've discovered a new favorite hamburger restaurant. Hamburger hook. Oh, interesting. They're all lined up. Yes. Do your stupid wisp attack that probably takes almost as many seconds. No, it doesn't. But it would be funny to imagine it taking as almost as long in terms of seconds as it does damage. Okay, so I can't do lightning damage to these guys, because, they, heal with it, so. They're like 180 health, I think. I don't know if our cannon shoots them all in a line or not. I really hope it would, but it doesn't. Alright, so high kick, jackknife, and we got one more left. So then tornado slash, seraphim rush. There we go, that actually like worked for once. Chaos normally hits so poorly. I mean, it's not like I expect him to hit well. He's a fucking black mage, essentially. So, I mean, he shouldn't be meleeing too much, but he's useful to have to melee with when I do have him. Okay, let's use Life Shot on you. You guys are lagging behind in terms of levels. I think I might need to start swapping them in for some grinding. Don't want to. Yeah. Like, he is basically the Black Mage character, right? Chaos, can you use... Like, how many ether points do you have? Not enough to do anything with them. And neither does Ziggy. Cosmos doesn't either. I mean, like, I could have Cosmos teach. You know what I should do, actually? I should have you transfer Life Shot to Chaos. Because then... Chaos has a cheaper single-person heal. Yeah, I'm liking that. Okay. Okay, here's the UMN column. Let's make a save. I really wish I could pan the camera a little bit. Okay, so I'm assuming that's blocking the elevator from coming up or something. And then I'm gonna be able to bring the elevator up now that I've destroyed that. It's my guess, at least. I mean, like, I do just like wantonly destroying things, so, you know. There's that. The elevator is currently in emergency shutoff mode. Please confirm the safety of the surrounding area and disarm the safety devices located on each floor if you wish to reactivate it. Okay. Seems like a royal pain in the ass to reset the elevator. But whatever. Let's keep looking for more things that are keeping the elevator from being, you know, used. Okay, so basically this is an office area here. I feel like I should be able to blow that up. Some weird fucked up plants.
I guess there's no choice but to fight.
Okay, let's have you use flame wings and see how much damage that does. I'm curious how much damage flame wings will do to these plant things. I mean, like, it does a nice chunk of damage. But It's nothing like amazing. Yay, points times four. Okay, everybody's guarding.
Ready? Lunar seal.
I'm hoping that guarding doesn't mean I get to, or they get to do a brutal, like, counterattack, because that would be really unpleasant.
Let's go.
So at least get one more of these gone. Blaster. Okay, cancel, because 72 is how much health it had, and I did 79. And guarding doesn't seem like it takes that much less damage. Alright, now it does, though. Okay, let's boost Chaos back in, and then have Cosmos attack one of the ones that's guarding, because she's going to do way more damage using a three-move attack. Although, I guess I should have had her kill this, because we were on the turn where... Yeah, that was dumb, actually, now that I'm thinking about that. Because I would have gotten more points, either double or quadruple, or I guess 10 times, but... okay, so then from here, let's have Ziggy do laser blade, laser swing. Actually, what? I didn't have him do his special ability, and that was dumb. Alright.
Let's go!
Boost Ziggy back in.
Let's go.
I'm assuming it's dead now. Yeah, okay.
The first rule of survival.
The first rule of acquisition. The 390th rule of acquisition. Now I've got Star Trek on the brain, I guess. Come over here, you fuck noodle.
Watch the enemy closely and react quickly.
Charge it. Our cannon.
Holy fuck, fuck. Cosmos back. Yeah. Bringing Cosmos back. Yeah! Bring Chaos in, and then I'll boost Ziggy again in case I need him.
Ready? Lunar seal. Come on, everyone. We still have a long ways to go.
Apparently, these plants are destructible. Not the other ones, but these ones are. Alright, I don't want to blow that up until I have a target for it. Okay, so this takes me upstairs, which is probably where I have to go. But I want to make sure that there's nothing else in here. Come over here, please. Hey, over here. Over. Do you understand what over here means, you stupid fucking plant? Okay, so the plant actually will not come over here. That's interesting. What does this say over here? Anything? No. Okay. So the biggest problem is the way that the camera is, there could be stuff for those cubicles, and I can't tell without just going in there and spamming. This is really weird having these beads in, because like every now and again I just talk kind of, you know, like, and then I feel like the like weights in my hair bounce. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Because I forget for a second that I have them in. It's like, ah, la, 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 la. I mean, looks like a 6-1 half a dozen the other for these guys, so. Let's just let this turn play out as ever, or as it's going to, or whatever. But I really like these beads. I think my only complaint about them is I kind of wish that they crimped in place instead, like they've got like a little metal insert to help fill out the gap in, like in between the hair and hold it in place. Which works, and it's like, you know, I can take it on and off without like damaging any of the metalwork and whatnot. But I feel like if it crimped in place, it would work almost a bit better. But that's just me being, you know, nitpicky wanker that I was, or that I am. If you're curious as to where they're from, my husband got them from an Etsy store called Dwarvendom.
Let's go.
But yeah, like you can see how they like slide on and stuff there. If you're curious, I mean, anyone who is more than welcome to. I've actually gotten asked that once already. I think the first night I had them in that I posted a picture of them, I had a message in my Facebook. My Facebook message is being like, where are those from? I must know. Let's hope that kills that.
Let's go.
Just because I don't want to get attacked again. It really just annoys me. Yay! Death to the weird plant things! I think what I might want to do is go to, like, Michael's or something and get some other beads to put into it and then just use these beads to hold those beads in place or whatnot. But I really like the layout that I have now, so part of me is kind of like, don't fuck with it. Don't fuck with it. You go and you do anything, and you'll just be annoyed with yourself later for having fucked with it. Ah! I have obtained a magical hat? What? Where is said magical hat? Prevents lost, fizz def +4. Cool. And that's why I wanted to check all of those. Everyone loves Magical Trevor because the things that he does are ever so clever. Look at him now, it's a beer in the cow. Where is he now? The kid. Okay, do I have enough TP to put up their other skills into the high slots? Mm-hmm. Or tech attacks, I mean. So I actually could boost either of them. I'm gonna boost our drill, because since it costs more, that's obviously better, right? Seeing I got notifications. I will be happy when all this car crap is done, and every time I hear my phone vibrate, I'm like, okay, is that something I need to go pay attention to? Is that something I need to go pay attention to? Is that something I need to go... Okay, good. No, it isn't. Okay. Okay, so he doesn't even have, like, Heaven's Wrath equipped anywhere. So let's put this in our high attack slot. And then set this here, and then let's set it for this one as well. And then that way I can do triangle square in either order and still get to angel wings, and not, like, you know, be like, which one is it set up for that I should be doing here? And you have meteor shot that I haven't used either, but meteor shot seems to be a far attack. Yeah, that's kind of annoying. But to put that in a high slot seems really hard. Alright, let's then upgrade Cyber Kick so that we can put that in a high slot. And then increase the power on it. And then increase the speed on Meteor Shot. And then, since I can already summon Lightning Fist, we'll do it this way. Okay, cool. Okay. We can go up over here too, can't we? I'm assuming that these are pretty equal, like it shouldn't matter what side I go up on, but we'll find out pretty quickly. I'm guessing that they both just lead to the same common room on the second floor. Yes, of course. Press all the buttons. Okay, so and there's more elevator stuff that we gotta blow up. They don't go to the same place after all, actually. Interesting. That seems dumb. Hey, you want to cross? Eh. Well, good fucking luck. Okay, I think we got the status effect off. Yup, sweet. Okay, so then I am going to go punch our drill. And then I'm gonna boost chaos and go back because I didn't mean to do that. And then do a tornado slash and a Heaven's Wrath.
Heaven's Wrath.
then with chaos, I am gonna do. How am I gonna do this? Okay. I'm gonna do a punch. Argyril. Now that it's Ziggy's turn, I'm gonna boost Chaos back in and have Ziggy do a high kick and a cyber kick.
Let's go.
And then with Chaos back in, I am gonna boost Ziggy and then have Chaos do Tornado Slash, Heaven's Wrath. And then I can boost Chaos again to come back in and do a Jackknife Cyber Kick on you. And if I need Ziggy back, I have him back because I've got another boost. But if not, then not. I mean, like, he's got so little health left that this shouldn't be an issue, but.
Ready? Heaven's Wrath.
There we go. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. What is this hemlock I've been picking up? So what was that unicorn horn? I forgot about that. It's a barter item, okay. And the hemlock is one. What? Interesting. So it sets the hit points on one ally to one. I'm assuming that must be used for situations where you get a boost on low hit points or something. Because otherwise that doesn't make any sense to me. So, like, I must have to come in here and use it. Like, I must have to come in here and then use the passport over top of the EVS point. Yeah. I think it's probably best not to think about it too much. Like, it's bombastic sci-fi. Like, bigger than life. It's one of those, like, just have some fun and don't think about it too much kind of things, right? Yeah, I don't understand. Oh, is it maybe the piece of the floor is meant to look like it's blown out? That's why it's not there. Okay. Yay, and the elevator's working! And now we have to go back down to the bottom floor, because that's how that works. That's how those things always work. Oh, you fixed the elevator! Go back down to it. And there's another one of these. Sigma Dress 9. And we do have the one for this one, so let's go in and see what the fuck's in here. Alright, so we got another robot arm. Or part, or something. Which I don't think does anything until we get all the pieces of the robot. And even then, I do not remember what the fuck it does. If only we could call the elevator from a different floor. That would be an amazing ability to have. I mean, why would you ever want a button to call an elevator to another floor? Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, Mr. Grumpy Pants, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, the UMN column is in here, so I think I'll make a save state. Like right here. And then go in the elevator. Actually, I should heal first and then go in the elevator. I mean, like, I should heal first and then make the save state, but... Laziness is getting the better of me on that regard. Oh, wait. I should have used that on Ziggy as well. I didn't notice that Ziggy's was low. Lower than I wanted it to be, at least.